People often say that truth is stranger than fiction, and every now and then, a true story comes to light that almost defies belief. Such is the life story of Tony Anthony, who, as a four-year-old boy, was taken from his parents in London to live with his grandfather in China. His grandfather, a kung fu grandmaster, trains Tony in the art of Shaolin monk traditions of kung fu. After many trials and much suffering, Tony eventually becomes the world kung fu champion. As time passes, Tony is invited to work for the International Kung Fu Federation, an elite bodyguard organization protecting some of the world's richest and most powerful people.
Instead of shooting somebody in their shoulder or their leg to disarm them, instead I would shoot to kill. I would shoot them straight in the face.
Then, tragedy strikes, and Tony falls into a downward spiral of self-destruction, which turns him into a bloodthirsty and violent gangster. Tony is subsequently incarcerated into the notorious Nicosia Central Prison, where he finds every form of human depravity.
I'm half Chinese, half Italian. I was born in England. When I was born, my father contracted an illness called multiple sclerosis. The illness really affected his health pretty rapidly, and really my parents weren't able to look after me anymore. And I think I was probably somewhat of an accident anyway. I don't think my mum and dad really planned to have me at all at this time of their lives. And when I was four, my dad had got so ill that they sent me away into China. I was sent to my grandparents, and I was raised in southern China in a place called Guangdong, which is a province. I was actually raised in a place called Guangzhou. And basically, my grandparents were going to raise me for about 8 years. My grandfather, he raised me in a very harsh way. He raised me on a bamboo cane, and whenever he would speak to me, he'd always hit me in my head with his cane. Well, I was only four, and well, really, you don't question things when you're four. I just pretty much felt I was naughty most of the time, and I just felt I wasn't liked at all. So I would never question anything. It hurts an awful lot, but I guess what hurt me more than the physical pain was really the emotional and the mental pain. I just really felt hated and naughty all the time. If my grandfather was going to teach me an important lesson, he'd always beat me around the sides of my face, and my ears would bleed frequently. He really wasn't a person to meddle with at all. My grandfather would do horrible things to me, like he'll rush into my bedroom in the early hours of the morning, like 2 or 3 in the morning, and he would wake me up with a bucket of water. He would throw this bucket of water over me, and as he charged into the room, and I'd wake up screaming for my life. I thought I was being killed. And if there's anything my grandfather couldn't tolerate, it would be screaming or crying or whinging. And so he would beat me all the more until I shut up. In those first days, he would beat me until he totally knocked me out. My grandmother would bring me around again, and it was really quite a horrific childhood that I had. I would eventually get up before him, and I'll get myself clothed, and we'll go into the stone courtyard. And my grandfather would teach me these very strange and weird exercises. And I had to copy everything that he did. My grandfather was a grandmaster in Kung Fu, and Kung Fu has been a tradition passed down through the generations in my family for over 500 years, from father to son and from father to son until it was passed down to me. And really, my grandfather's goal in those 8 years while I was going to live with him was very much to pass on that tradition in the most effective way he could, so that one day I could pass it on to the next generation. All my cousins are all girls, and it's considered better luck to pass this down to a boy than to a girl. Very narrow-minded point of view. Because I was the only boy in a very large family, I guess I was the only option for them to teach. So perhaps that's why my grandfather was especially hard with me. The book's called Taming the Tiger, because he would teach me the movements of wild and exotic animals and insects, from tigers to monkeys to snakes to praying mantis. And we focused on the tiger style. We would actually study the movements of real animals as well, so I didn't really learn in a conventional sense. I didn't learn in a gym like you do in the Western world, where there's at least some degree of health and safety and child protection. I learned in the woods, and under extreme conditions where I was beaten day by day by day. Really, in those 8 years, my grandfather really just broke me in like nothing more than an animal. And although my story may seem interesting to you, for me, really, my childhood was nothing more than a nightmare. By the time I was 12, my mum and dad had saved enough money for me to live with them in the UK. So I was then put on a plane and sent back to England. I was living with them in a small council flat in North London, and it was so hard to settle into a normal family life. My mum was very ashamed of her background and her nationality being Chinese, because her family had cut her off from marrying out of the Chinese community and marrying an Italian. And so she always spoke to me in English, and I guess I learned English pretty quickly, but all I could speak was Cantonese. And going to school was so hard because, of course, I came across many bullies at school, like you have everywhere in the world. And there was one boy in particular, he'd always be gunning for me all the time. He gave me a hard time, but, you know, I was so timid. You could do anything you wanted. You could thump me, call me horrible words, and I wouldn't do anything. I was taught not to. But this boy, one day, he just pushed me too far. He was calling my mum horrible swear words, and, well, I guess swear words are probably the first things you learn in a foreign language. And he just really upset me, and he was calling my mum these swear words, and, you know, we were just two little kids in a playground pushing each other around. He thumped me on my shoulder, and, well, I really beat the hell out of him. I beat him so badly that I never had a single problem after that from anybody at school. It didn't matter if they were older than me or bigger than me. I think everybody became slightly more respectful of me and wary of me because of my ability. I was looked up to by many, and you know, I guess because my grandfather wasn't looking over my shoulder, I began to abuse my ability. And I began to push my weight around a lot more than I had before this incident. And I began to pick on all the bullies at school. But I guess in doing so, I'm the one that ended up becoming the bully. And I'm so ashamed of that, because I really think the bullies are nothing more than cowards. Really, as I grew older, my grandfather had an arrangement with the International Kung Fu Federation, an organization based in Switzerland and Geneva. They are one of many organizations around the world that are there to preserve the teachings of Kung Fu. And this organization, they sponsored me to continue training in London. And I was training in a school connected to the Shaolin Temple, UK. I was training under a person called Mr. Chang, and he was a really great guy. I was so young, but I was actually more advanced than he was. Because he was older than me, he mentored me and guided me, and I began to develop my own technique in Kung Fu. As I got older, they'll pay for me, this organization, to travel back to Asia, to China and Thailand and Pakistan, where I would enter many different competitions. Many of them were full contact, freestyle competitions, where there are really hardly any rules at all. And really anything, you could do anything in these fights, and so often people got very badly injured, and from time to time even killed. But I never lost a single competition. And I was doing very well. Later, I entered the World Championships between 1987 and 1989, and I held the world title for 3 years in a row. Again, I don't really think much of these competitions, because they're only for the younger students. They want to get a medal and make a name for themselves, get a trophy and what have you. Are you with me? And really, that's something which I wanted to do. There are so many grandmasters and advanced students that just never enter these competitions. They don't really need to prove themselves in any way at all. But for me, this was, you know, something pretty impressive at the time. My grandfather, in his late 60s and early 70s, could quite easily handle about 10 of me. So really, it was a nonsense. But I began to work for this organization. I became one of their international instructors, and I would travel to schools teaching martial science around the world, and we would be observing the students and the teachers and making sure they're teaching Kung Fu to the highest level. I did this for a short while, until there was an opportunity for me to change my job in this company, and I worked for the security division. And what our organization would do is that we would run many training courses, run in conjunction with various other organizations, and we would train men and women how to become close